delay.
What's up, guys? Rob Van Dam here. What? Yeah.
Oh. Oh, God. So hopefully you guys like the intros now.
Yeah.
I put those on there to signify the fact that we're now quality again.
Bro, it was like really radical. Yeah.
We have a special guest, and shockingly, no, it's not Rob Van Dam.
It's not me. Oh my God, it's somebody else.
This Rob Van Dam gimmick is gonna make me kill myself. It's just so constantly there. It's like, ah! It's literally in one episode gone from so over with me to fucking die.
Since we won't know for like another 6 weeks if it's over with the fans, it's just gonna keep happening.
That's true. Much.
All right, so, Nathaniel, introduce yourself. Who are you?
Hi.
Oh, there you go. Hi. Yeah, give me a... Who's your favorite wrestler?
Rob Van Dam!
Rob Van Dam! Hey!
Wow! Yeah!
Wow!
All right.
All right, welcome to...
Let's get going.
Jesus Christ. Welcome to the MCI Center in D.C., because Raw, you fucks.
Yeah. By the way, we can't see the gimmick because if he screen shares with us, it's just gonna fucking crap out.
Yeah.
Good gimmick.
It's some weird fucking stupid bullshit with like a new computer, even though this is more powerful than my fucking last one, apparently. Sure.
Loser.
Let's do this fucking show. We start off not in my fucking America. It's an 89A. Taker and Kane are in the ring. I don't even remember what they say. What do they say?
They said something about, What was the game? What was Not in America about?
They were just like, oh, we got the tag belts.
And then, like...
Something about Stacy Keebler.
Something, I don't know. I remember, at one point... I know
the Dudley's gimmick. I just don't know what the fuck to start. Okay, so basically, Taker and Kane are in the ring. Maybe they're not doing anything. Maybe they're just standing there. And, like...
Are they just putting themselves over, basically?
Yeah, they're just like, hey! Okay. And everybody's like, who's that guy?
Who's that guy?
And it's literally just some random guy. And so Bubba Ray and D-Von come out, and they've still got, like, this weird woman with them. We really don't know who the fuck she is. And then Bubba's just like, yeah, we didn't kidnap. This is Stacy Keebler. We're not holding her against her will anymore. Due to the Dudleyville culture, we've actually appointed her royalty in Dudleyville. She is now a duchess, actually.
Duchess of Dudleyville.
Yeah. And in the ring, Taker goes, "Hoy, not in my fucking America, she doesn't! Get back in the fucking kitchen!" And then they brawl.
Get back in the fucking kitchen.
Because Taker's a big, good old red-blooded American.
Yeah, and then, like, there's, like, a reference to, like,
Kane's
Undertaker
like,
wanting someone like Donald Trump to be president.
Yeah. And then Kane's like, I will set the monarchy on fire.
I pop.
Hey, he's the big red machine for a reason.
He's the big red cunt for a reason.
Taker's just like, oh, my brother and his commie values. That's to open up the show, because... Yeah.
What?
Moving forward, we got a 78B. We quickly cut to the announce table, and Paul Heyman stands up and says, "Hey, Jim." Jim's like, "What? What?
What?"
And Paul's like, "I'm gonna go get some milk. I'll be back." And Paul leaves, and JR's like, "Okay.
See you later."
We move forward. It's a 79B. William Regal beats Matt Hardy in 13:28 by submission with the Regal Stretch.
Good shit.
Regal gets an 80.
Doesn't he beat Jeff Hardy?
Yeah, that's what I said.
He said Matt Hardy.
Oh, well, they're the same person in my mind.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Jeff Hardy gets a 74.
Good shit.
But Matt beats Jeff.
Matt beats Jeff?
Yeah.
As this plane flies by my house, I don't know if you hear that.
It's them. They figured it out.
What?
I don't fucking know.
Jesus Christ, Tuck. Get your shit together.
I hate everything again.
Good. That makes the best content for these episodes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he wins, and what are the stakes? What are the consequences of that win, brother?
There isn't.
Exactly. No. That is WWF. Let's go.
I've just noticed. I think you can hear my echo now, which is kind of shit. But
where?
Like on your side, but whatever.
On my side?
Yeah.
I'll move you over here. Though.
Hold on. How about that?
Yeah, no, you can still hear me. It's fine.
For fuck's sake.
Nobody gives a fuck, to be honest, at this point, anyways.
Yeah, good point.
I started actually shoot watching. By calling this is quality content. This is some fucking quality content. The fuck?
This is quality, brother.
You would not be here if you wanted quality content, alright?
That's true.
Fuck
that, you don't
here.
Subscribe to this channel for content.
Literally.
Hail Saban.
Hail Saban. moving forward. It's a 77B as William Regal just straight up tries to break Jeff Hardy's leg, and then Matt comes down and 370.
Oh wait, I have to leave, don't
get
I?
Get the fuck out of here! What are you doing?
Sorry.
Jesus Christ! And so Lita's there too, and yeah, they run him off.
Yeah,
and Regal's like, ah. Moving forward.
Good job.
Good job.
Fuck. Fucking idiots. Oh my god. Great.
It's a 52.
Wait, way to give Nathaniel a good spot, too. That was really, yeah.
I did.
I gave him the fucking mic so he could do something, and it was like, oh yeah, give him 2 seconds. That's fine. Go ahead.
All right, 52D plus. Jerry Lynn's on the roof of a building.
Yeah, he is.
And he's bought himself fucking sniper rifle.
Why?
And he fucking puts one round in there and he cocks it back and he looks at the camera and he says, nothing, because he's uncharismatic.
That's true.
And he just, and he's, he.
Well, would he say nothing or would he say something really boring?
He'd just be like, Dean Malenko. And then goes back to.
Yep. Yep.
And so, there's just some random guy with Jerry Lynn while, like, they're trying to snipe Dean Malenko in his car.
Is it the guy? Oh, yeah.
It's
okay.
It's not the guy in the segment, so I don't know who this guy is.
Oh, it's a separate guy.
It's just some random guy. I don't know, friend of Jerry Lynn's, maybe? Okay. And so he lines up the shot, you know, and he starts to pull down on the trigger, and all of a sudden the nuke system says, whoa, look! Is that a cat? And Jerry Lynn's like, what the fuck? What? And looks over, and on the other side of the roof, like, I don't know, maybe like 10 feet away,
yeah,
there's just some guy, like, dancing.
He's dancing.
And Jerry looks at the guy, he's like, it's not a fucking cat, that's a... Oh, shit. It's Ernest Miller, folks.
God damn it.
Hey, Arno.
Jesus Christ.
I'm done. Fucking goats.
Anyways, Ernest Miller's here.
For every episode, and be Ernest Miller.
Ernest Miller's here.
Meow.
Meow.
He does the Nakamura gimmick. Meow.
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 All right.
We're gonna move forward.
Yeah, please.
It's a 71C plus here. It's the King of the Ring thing. The Quiche versus the yeah.
Yeah, what? Oh, it's me and Rikishi. Ah.
It's me, Rikishi.
Me and Rikishi. Yeah. I'm fighting him. I'm gonna kick him. I'm gonna kick him a lot.
Dude, for the Rock.
Man. Ah, man. Oh.
So Bravo Day beats Rikishi.
Frog Splash.
Jesus Christ. Defends the hardcore belt. Moves forward in the King of the Ring.
Yeah.
As Tuck hangs himself.
Literally.
Take a deep breath.
We're gonna move forward. It's a 69C plus. We go back to Jim Ross at the announce table, and he's like, where the fuck is Paul?
Anybody know what the fuck happened to Paul?
Where did Paul go? And like, he brings over some guy, and it's like, I don't know, who the fuck's the ring announcer at this point? Yeah, that guy. He's like, hey, guy, what happened to Paul? God, my echo's so fucking bad.
Dude.
If I move you over here, does that help?
No. Oh, actually does. No.
Jesus.
No, it doesn't.
How?
I don't know.
Turn you down.
What a fucking episode.
Yeah, this is a good episode.
Kill me. We were back to quality in that. Me, yeah.
It's
the best. That's the saving grace of this.
That is. Nathaniel saved this episode.
He did. Wow. Mm-hmm. Anyways, Jim Ross can't find Paul Heyman.
Well, he's not looking for him. He's just not there.
We go backstage to Kurt Angle, and Kurt Angle informs us he's getting a restraining order against Chris Benoit because Chris Benoit has assaulted him too many times.
The second restraining order of the series, the first being Lita against me, of course.
I feel like a whole bunch of brawls and restraining orders just are this series.
Pretty much.
You can probably skip, like, the next, like, 5 weeks of TV.
Yeah.
You just skip through these episodes. It's okay.
Just skip them, quite frankly.
Unless, like, big developments happen and, like, there's a fucking plane crash and half our roster dies.
Yeah, which is a gimmick.
Yeah, it's a gimmick. Anyways, we're gonna move forward. It's an 87B+. We have a main event. Triple H is gonna fight Diamond Dallas Page.
Yo, big ups to Cam, who just sent me a DM on Discord. He said, Kim Kardashian is a weeaboo now. I'm not gonna further inquire about what that means.
Fuck off, Cam. You're a moron.
Me, yeah.
You fucking break my PS4. Holy shit, dude.
I did not do it.
All right, anyways, as that goes on in the background, fucking Triple H is talking about DDP, and he's going to beat him up because DDP's old, and Triple H hates old people.
Fair.
We move forward. It's a 73B-. What the fuck?
What match is that?
China versus Stevie Richards.
Whoa, dude. Holy
China
shit.
The god.
Wow. Oh,
China and Stevie Richards have great chemistry.
What the fuck?
They are fucking rivals. Anyways, Bull Buchanan shows up. He's back. He beats up China.
So Stevie Richards is winning the women's championship.
Apparently. Like, year-long feud against China.
I love it.
So, Bull Buchanan's back. He stops the match from even happening. China wins by DQ. Yeah? We good? We good? We spicy? Yeah. Thank you. Let's move. It's a 67C+, as Rey Mysterio de Guerrero talk about how, the dastardly edging Christian, you know, they're trying to keep the honest Mexican man down, but there can't be no keeping the Mexican man down, because they're luchadors. They fly. It's what they do. Rey versus Christian. Not yet. Raven cuts a promo, and what does Raven say? You take it.
What does Raven say, Nathaniel?
Meow!
Meow! Oh, no! That's Raven. Not Raven. That's Raven. Ernest Miller.
Raven says, "Ah, shit, wrong animal," and that's the segment.
Kaka. This is a stupid gimmick.
Raven says he's going to win King of the Ring.
Okay, there you go.
Meow.
Meow.
we move into Christian Rey Mysterio. 74B-, Christian draws with Rey Mysterio when Eddie Guerrero Edge run in, big chaos brawl, boy. Rey with a 75 in-ring performance, Christian with a 67.
Hold on, did you say a brawl in the ring?
Yes.
That never happens on this series.
Never. That's not how this series fucking works.
Nope.
We move forward, it's Scott Steiner. Yeah, you're gonna want to fucking just mute yourself because the echo's gonna be so fucking terrible.
Oh, yeah, let's do it.
I don't even know what the hell to say. Who's Scott Steiner facing soon? He's already talked about Raven.
I don't remember.
Who the fuck can Scott Steiner... Give me someone, and Scott Steiner will shoot on them.
Perry Saturn.
Well, you see the distance right from the Saturn... To the planet of the Scott Steiner, because Earth is my world. I rule it with the Sid Vicious, and from the planet there's the math the There's the distance. It's 47 kilometers. But if you take the 47, you split it in half. That's like three. And I've three matches. I'm three matches away from being the king of the ring, being the greatest king of the ring ever in the history of the king of the ring, because the ring is the king of Scott Steiner. And I'm the big booty king. Daddy. Look at his fucking muscles. Anyways, we move forward, okay. And Jim Ross is just like, where the
Nathaniel's,
fuck?
Nathaniel was putting you over before the mic was muted.
Oh, was he?
Yeah.
Good shit.
What'd you say, brother?
Sound better than the real Scott. Real Scott Steiner.
Scott Steiner.
The fucking Scott Steiner. The fucking. Anyways, JR's fucking confused. Where the fuck did Paul Heyman go? And
yeah,
then
like Paul Heyman, right? How long is he's been gone for? Like an hour and a half getting milk.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden, just some creepy, like pervert pedophile guy from the crowd crawls in. And he's like, "I know where to get milk," and then just kind of sits next to JR. And JR's like, "Okay."
Okay. That's it?
And then Jerry all of a sudden goes, "Wait a minute. Are you Jerry Lawler?" And Jerry Lawler's like, "Yes."
No. No, he says no.
He's just like, "No." Jerry's like, "Oh. Okay."
Okay.
Let's move forward.
Okay.
It's main event time. It's an 85 B+.
Okay.
We cracked the B+.
We did it, finally. Shit.
In a superb match, Diamond Dallas Page defeated Triple H. Holy fuck. In 1928 by pinfall, the handful of tights. During the match, nice. We also had Booker T distract Triple H. Holy fuck. DDP has pinned the Intercontinental Champion.
Wow.
Triple H gets an in-ring performance of 94. DDP with a 74. That's okay. DDP's fucking old.
He is. That's true.
There are, like, no negatives in this. So, like, great.
That's great, yeah. Oh, yeah, that was the gimmick. We were talking about the announcers.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Perfect.
And Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler.
It was because fucking Paul Heyman's terrible.
No, not because Paul Heyman's terrible, because fucking Michael Cole's terrible.
Oh, that's true.
Scum of the earth, Michael Cole. But yeah, overall, you know, pretty damn good match. What does this mean?
DDP probably gets a shot at something.
I don't know, but Booker T pinned Triple H, like, last week.
Maybe they both have a shot now.
Oh, good God.
Maybe it's going to be like a triple threat.
Oh, but we're not over yet. It's a 99A star. There's just a big fucking brawl. All the fucking boys come down. It's a big fucking brawl. We're going to the Royal Rumble.
Wait a minute.
What?
Are you telling me there was a brawl to end the show?
Jesus Christ. All right, end the show. We get a 88 B+. Up an 8.
We did it.
Praise Jesus. Woo! Or don't. I don't care.
Meow!
Meow! Meow.